Welcome back. How does this meditation cure psychosomatic diseases? Now we are going to talk about it. So every thought that we have releases a corresponding chemical in our body. For example, you know, the moment you remember about your favorite food, naturally saliva comes. Or rather, like say, you know, there is a snake over there. Actually, it has done nothing to your body. But then some fear happens and you will start shivering the body. So similarly, when you get hurt to your body, you don't feel so fantastic. You get that pain in the mind. So this body and mind, they are very closely connected. Whatever happens to the body will have corresponding action on the mind. Whatever happens to the mind will have a corresponding reaction in the level of body. So they are not actually too separate. You know, it is there within this physiology. So now, when you have got so much tension, when you have got so many worries, you know, when you have got so much stress, they are all releasing so many chemicals in your system. And all these tensions that you are having, normally they get out of the system when you take rest. When you take rest, all these chemicals that are released, they come to blood and then they are again purified, they go out of your body. But some deep-rooted tensions, some deep-rooted chemicals, you know, these blocks that are settled in the body, they don't easily get out of the system. Say like, you know, a person has passed away in your life, very important person. So will that simply go away? No, it lasts for so long time. Say like you have suffered a lot, you know, for some whatever the reason. So that severe suffering, you don't forget it so easily. It lasts so much, so long in your mind. So, you know, just like in the previous episode, how we were talking about the identities and how they are causing problems to our system, how we are developing various health issues in our body. Now, if you can actually take deep rest, the unwanted material from the body will go out. If there is no sufficient rest to the body, that which needs to be eliminated from the body will not go out. And if the waste is remaining for so long time in the body, it becomes a toxins. And these toxins are, you know, many things, they will cause so many health issues again. So here, when you are meditating, it is a very great curative. You get enormous amount of rest in meditation. When you get more rest, you eliminate all dirt from the body. Normally, during the night when you sleep, all the waste is collected and then it is being thrown out of the body. That happens when you give sufficient rest. But if your mind is all the time functioning, and you are not giving proper rest to the mind, your body, you know, the same corresponding reaction will be there on the level of body. When you don't sleep, do you feel very nice? When you don't sleep properly in the night, in the morning, do you feel very fresh? No. But if you have slept very tight, if you have got very sound sleep, then how will you feel in the morning? Very nice. So here, when you are meditating, by gaining more rest to the mind and to the body, all the body organs rejuvenate very well. With the rejuvenation, again, you will start functioning in this, you will start working. So as we were talking about how the healthy body mind is very much essential to perform your task duty well, you must make this meditation as a practice in your life. This helps to a greater extent in our life to overcome many hurdles. It not only works on the level of body, it works on the level of mind. You're clearing all the all the garbage, all the dirt from the mind too. When you are meditating, you're emptying the, you're getting so much space in the mind. You're eliminating so many thoughts which are not necessary. Your focus enhances, your space enhances, your concentration tremendously it goes up. By meditating, of course, everybody knows there are so many advantages of meditation. Now, the next question is how to meditate? How many varieties of meditations are there? So these things, you know, you will learn when you come to our, when you drop into our retreat programs during weekends. So we will be more happy to host you for the meditation programs and yoga, pranayama, human well-being, health, all these areas of the life. So by meditating, of course, definitely we all know that there are so many benefits. Now I'm going to explain what are the benefits that we directly get and indirectly get. There are physical benefits, there are mental benefits, there are social benefits, there are emotional benefits by meditating. So in the first level so far we have seen the physical benefits of doing meditation. So now what are the mental benefits of meditation? Earlier in the previous episode we were talking about how all these identities are causing so many problems. One of the greatest thing that you get is you really get back to your true nature by meditating. You don't experience any problem. As long as you feel that I am this, I am that, then you will have the problem. When you feel that I am a student, then you will have the problem of submitting these assignments, that, all these things. But the moment when you feel that, you know, I'm just a child or I'm nothing, so that nothingness happens in the meditation. You get rid of all the problems in the life instantly by meditating for some time. You will start finding all other opportunities. Now, so far we have been looking into only one possibility that has been closed in your life. But when you come out of it, when you meditate, you will start seeing many other opportunities that are open. So you will start working on that. So this is one of the greatest thing. So now in simple language, in spiritual language, they say meditation is the solution to all the problems. Whether you say physical, whether you say mental, whether you say psychological, whether you say social, communal, you know, so much of harmony comes by a person meditating. This is the greatest thing what our India has given to the whole world. We have gifted this meditation to the whole world. This, what is about, you know, you may call it as Zen or you may call it with any other name. How does this Zen come? This Dhyan has become Jnan, Gnan, Gyan. Then slowly it started becoming Zen. You know, there are so many fantastic techniques in the Buddhist meditations and everywhere. Fundamentally, realizing who you truly are is the purpose of meditation. Getting back to your true nature, unlimited potential, is the meditation. There are so many varieties of meditation, of course. Again, here, you know, in English, they simply call it meditation. But in Yoga Shastra or in Patanjali Yoga Shastra, they say it like Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. You know, it is very clearly defined, each state. So these things can be learnt when you come to our retreats. We will clearly explain what is this Dharana, what is Dhyana, what is Samadhi. Of course, mostly, I mean, generally people think Samadhi as, you know, some tomb or, you know, after a person dies, they bury it. It is not so. There is a very fantastic meaning to it. It's a great state. And then other thing, of course, about dhyana, about dharana. They are very important, essential. Like dhyana is about the concentration. Dharana is to continuously be with, like chanting Ram Nam or any name, whatever the name that you have taken. So here, when it comes to the, we spoke about physical benefits of meditation, we spoke about mental benefits of meditation. What are the social benefits of meditation? Very simple. As long as you are being carried away by I am this and I am that, one strong identity, you are always for that person. But the moment when you meditate, you become a human. You will start approaching the other person as a human. That is the greatest way of receiving people, everyone, welcoming, including. The moment you exclude, you develop hatred. The moment you include, you develop love. So this is the greatest community benefit of meditating. Happy meditation. Thank you.